Hi, and welcome to the short introduction of DATPROF Privacy. Privacy is a Windows tool that enables users to create advanced masking templates for complex databases. First, let's start up Privacy to create a new template from scratch. We will create a new project with the name Demo Template. And Privacy consists of three steps. The first is the project settings, in where the connection to the database can be defined and metadata can be imported or synchronized. We will now define the connection by clicking Edit Connection and choosing one of the previously saved connections. Next, we will import the metadata of the database. We will import all the tables and foreign keys of the demo database. Privacy will not import any data, but only the structure of the database. We have successfully imported the metadata and we can start configuring our masking template. To get a visual representation of the data model, we can visualize it by going to Visualize and then Visualize Data Model. For now, we will close this window and focus on adding masking functions. Most of the privacy-sensitive data is stored in the customer table. To add a masking function, select one or more columns and right-click to add a function. We will first create a shuffle function on the last name column. The shuffle function will switch values and this will result in new first and last name combinations. Each function can be conditionally applied. In this case, we will only shuffle the values where our customers are of the type civilian. For the rest of the customers, we will scramble all name fields. The scramble function replaces all characters with an X or a 1. If we want to replace all first names with synthetic desk data, we can use the random lookup function to search values in a seed data library. In this case, my DPF first names male table contains male first names. We also have to add a condition to make sure that we will replace only the male first names with the synthetic ones. Now we can clone this function and change it to replace the female first names. If we want to combine values of multiple columns, we use the custom expression, for example, to create new email addresses, based on the first letter of the first name combined with the last name. We have to make this function dependent on the other functions to prevent building email addresses based on production values. In the dependency editor, you can define predecessors and successors to the function. And in this case, all name-related functions must be executed before we build new email addresses. Now let's replace all existing bank account numbers with valid IBANs. We have now modeled a simple masking template for our demo database. To actually execute it, you have two options. During development of your template, you can execute it directly from Privacy. When your masking template is finished, you can also generate it as a runtime application that can be uploaded in DATPROF Runtime. Runtime is a central test data portal to monitor, execute and self-service your test data within your organization. There is a lot more to cover about privacy and runtime, but that's for another time. Thank you for your time, and if there is anything unclear, let us know.